So the C part says ki classify the activity into business activity either as a primary or support activity on the basis of value chain, right? So you are given four situations, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Material handling and warehousing. So this particular thing is one. So how you place it? This is a regular function. So this is a primary activity as per value chain analysis. The second item is purchase of raw material, supply and other consumables. So purchase of Now, if you are purchasing on a regular basis items which are useful, you are supporting the business. So this is a support activity. Third is order processing and distribution. So if you are processing order and making distribution happen, it is a primary activity. So look, one mark each for each section is coming, so it's more a mathematical scenario where you can secure full marks. Selection, placement, and promotion of employee. So what you notice? What type of activity it is? This is a thing which is supporting. Therefore, it is a activity which is a support activity. So friend, one mark each for each section. The next part is on Pareto law or Pareto analysis. So how Pareto analysis is useful for profitability analysis? Pareto law, you already know, is 80-20 principle, which says from 20% of your time you can get 80% result, from 80% of time you get 20% result, right? This is the basic. Now if you apply it to the profitability analysis, you have certain conclusions. So what are the conclusions which might come as a solution for the business? So you can find right client, you can exclude unworthy or less paying clients, you can discontinue unprofitable segment, you can even offer discount to attract profitable customer, right? You can even identify high net worth individual, HNI clients. So these are the possibilities which you can use by analyzing the data, looking the aspects which are affecting the business, and you can plan out what is going to be more profitable for your business.